What I found interesting in the excerpts that I read was that he was really reluctant to be named Treasury Secretary. I mean, he kind of pushed back every which way, had his whole laundry list of excuses, and President Obama wouldn't hear any of it.
And I think the biggest, I mean, just from covering him and from the sense I got was family. This was a hard move for his family. I think it was hard on his wife. I think she would admit that now, that this was a tough time for him to take this job. But you know, at the end of the day, this was a job that a lot of people wanted, and I think to suggest that Tim Geithner wasn't really excited to be Treasury Secretary, didn't want that responsibility, at the end of the day, he took it. He served in that position. It was hard for him to go, as you saw at the end.
Yeah.
Hey, Carl, senior U.S. economist at Deutsche Bank. Do we have a sense now, for you working inside a bank, that we're past the notion that that could happen again? That point of no return?
Well, I mean, certainly in the current cycle, yes. I mean, will there be banking crises in the future? Absolutely. But, you know, as we look at Geithner's legacy, I mean, the track record speaks for itself. So whether he had the proper qualifications or not, he did a pretty phenomenal job. And I think what's really important here is he, you know, explains that, you know, the priority was not to be fair in the moment of crisis. Mm-hmm. The priority was to preserve the system. And then if you want to deal with fairness and income inequality and those types of issues, that's a peacetime program, not a mid-crisis.
What's the angle on this book out of Washington? The insiders like you, when you read stress tests, what are you looking for?
You know, I was there. I covered him closely. I'm looking for any discrepancy in what he was telling me publicly at the time.
And you one thing found that's, it yet.
I haven't found it yet. You know, there was the talk about the nationalization of the banks, which will be interesting. One area of candor which I see in the book is that Tim Geithner admits he's not a great communicator, doesn't like public speaking. I was there that first day when he delivered that first big speech on how they're going to deal with the crisis, how they're going to deal with those toxic assets. And he was a deer in the headlights. He did an interview with me afterwards. It was not a great moment of communication. The stock market reflected that.